If you're looking for a new router or mesh Wi-Fi system, you may have noticed that some of them support a standard called Wi-Fi 6E. If you want to know more about this E version of Wi-Fi 6, how it works, its advantages and disadvantages, and how it compares to Wi-Fi 6, then you should watch this video, and I will try to explain everything you need to know. Wi-Fi 6E is the same standard as Wi-Fi 6 or 802.11x with one key difference. It enables wireless networks and networking products such as routers to operate on a new 6 GHz frequency band. The previous Wi-Fi 6 standard, on which Wi-Fi 6E is based, delivers the same features but only on the traditional 2.4 and 5 GHz frequency bands. The E in Wi-Fi 6E comes from extended, outlining that this standard only extends the available frequencies that can be used to transmit Wi-Fi 6 signals. The E standard was announced in 2020 and finalized by the Wi-Fi Alliance in January 2021. But what is this 6 gig thing? It is the new frequency band used by the 6E standard and by the even more recent Wi-Fi 7 standard, which ranges from 5.9 to 5 GHz to 7.125. While older standards like Wi-Fi 6 or 5 were created for the 2.4 and 5 GHz bands, they weren't designed for the 6 GHz frequency. Therefore, older devices don't slow down 6 GHz networks, because they simply can't use this frequency for transmitting data. Due to the additional 6 GHz band, devices that support Wi-Fi 6E can benefit from a broader spectrum to work with. That means more channels and less interference from other devices. The table here shows the theoretical number of channels available on each band. 2.4 gig, 5 gig and 6 gig. This means that the 6 GHz band has the widest frequency range, approximately 1200 MHz. As a result, you can connect more devices to Wi-Fi 6E networks than you can when using older wireless networking standards. Another important difference is that the 6 GHz band is not used by radar devices or TV stations, resulting in less overall interference in crowded locations such as airports, their surroundings, or busy metropolitan areas. Except for Wi-Fi 6E using the new 6 GHz frequency, there's no other significant difference between these standards. However, when you look at Wi-Fi 6E routers and mesh Wi-Fi systems, you notice a couple of other differences. Wi-Fi 6 is available in all price ranges, from low-end to premium routers and networking devices. In contrast, 6E is mostly available on premium devices. Wi-Fi 6 routers and mesh systems offer backward compatibility on the 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz bands. In comparison, backward compatibility is unavailable on the 6 GHz added by Wi-Fi 6E routers. Even though most Wi-Fi 6 routers offer WPA3 encryption support, this type of encryption is usually disabled, so you must turn it on manually. On Wi-Fi 6E routers and mesh Wi-Fi systems, WPA3 is typically enabled by default. To compare the two standards in real life, I used two Wi-Fi 6E networking devices that we've reviewed in the past. ASUS ROG Rapture GT-AXE 16000, a premium router with incredibly powerful hardware, many features and a matching price, and TP-Link Deco XE75, a powerful mesh Wi-Fi 6E system designed to cover large spaces, with a dedicated wireless backhaul to provide better throughput. I used a relatively small apartment, arranged like in the diagram here. When testing the router, I placed it in the central area of the apartment. I first measured the signal strength using NetSpot. As you can see, the ROG Rapture delivered better signal strength when using the Wi-Fi 6 standard on the 5 GHz band than when using Wi-Fi 6E on 6 GHz. The same was true for the Deco. The 6 GHz band suffered from lower signal strength than the 5 and 2.4 bands. However, this doesn't necessarily mean you get a lower speed. It's just that you will get a smaller coverage area. To compare the speed of 6E versus 6, we used Passmark performance test to transfer data between two computers connected to the network. The average download speed offered by the Rapture was higher when using Wi-Fi 6E only in room 1, which is separated from the router by one wall. In all other rooms, Wi-Fi 6 delivered faster downloads. The difference was significant in room 2, separated from the router by two walls, with the second being rather thick. The upload speed offered by Wi-Fi 6E was faster than with Wi-Fi 6 in the rooms closest to the router. However, the smaller coverage area of Wi-Fi 6E meant that Wi-Fi 6 delivered faster uploads in room 2. We repeated the same speed measurements using the deco. Again, Wi-Fi 6E was marginally faster only in the room where the main unit of the deco was placed. However, in all the other rooms, Wi-Fi 6 outperformed 6E, especially when I moved further away from the main station. When measuring the upload speed, Wi-Fi 6E was faster than Wi-Fi 6 in the rooms where the 6 GHz band had great coverage. However, in room 2, Wi-Fi 6 again benefited from the larger coverage area of the 5 GHz frequency band and delivered faster uploads. So, which is faster? As you've seen from the measurements, there's no clear-cut answers. It depends on your router or mesh system, your specific area, the level of Wi-Fi interference, the devices you're connected to the network, etc. Based on my experience, I would say that when it comes to the download speed, both are just as fast, with small differences between them. However, regarding the upload speed, 6E tends to be faster. But Wi-Fi 6E has a smaller coverage area. Therefore, the further away you get from your router, the stronger signal strength and faster speeds you'll get from Wi-Fi 6. So, what are the benefits of Wi-Fi 6E? I'm quite conflicted. Yes, 6E opens up a new frequency band and delivers some benefits, but its value equation is not as clear-cut as it is with Wi-Fi 6. So, let's see who would benefit from using Wi-Fi 6E. Locations where wireless congestion and interference are a real issue. Networks that require a greater capacity for a large number of connected devices. People or businesses with 8K smart TVs who want to stream 8K content. Gamers who are into 4K or 8K cloud gaming, which requires lots of bandwidth and low latency. Or just users who frequently download or upload large files over the internet. What are the downsides? The 6 GHz wireless spectrum uses shorter wavelengths. While they are great for fast data transfers, they have a harder time traveling long distances and suffer greater interference from physical obstructions like walls or floors in a building. The result is that the 6 GHz band has a smaller coverage area than the 2.4 and 5 GHz bands used by Wi-Fi 6. Then, it requires new hardware designed to work with the 6 GHz band, and you generally get it on premium devices. But the list is getting longer by the day. And last but not least, Wi-Fi 6E routers and mesh systems tend to cost much more than their Wi-Fi 6 counterparts, which are now widely available. So all this being said, I'm curious about your choice. Will you jump on this Wi-Fi 6E bandwagon and buy a router or mesh system supporting this standard, or stay chill using Wi-Fi 6 or an even older standard? Comment below and share your perspective. I hope we've shed some light on this matter, and if you think we were able to do that, please subscribe to Technicalities. Pretty strange name we chose for our channel. For a detailed article on this topic, you can also check digitalcitizen.life, link in this video's description. Thanks for watching and good luck!